Matt Drudge back here on Drudge. Protesters today, I guess protesting the NRA thing out in Denver. I'm sitting here at the desk in Midtown Manhattan, speaking with Rory Masters, talk show host for 4 decades. And you have warned about the spiritual crisis we're having.
For 40 years.
And now it's all, with the media, the way it's, everything has been speeding up and everything's commercialized and ratings. If I see one more press release about which network is scoring the most ratings off these shootings, I think I'm going to lose it. What is happening to our culture where it's everything seems to feed on death and terror and trauma?
Well, any power that wants to control a country or a person must first demoralize. You cannot control a noble people because they have roots in themselves. As I said in the last segment, when you emotionalize and traumatize a person, for example, you're going to have this shooting. Well, there was a Texas Tower shooting. Remember that one?
Mm-hmm.
And instead of focusing in on the criminal, they focused in on the gun. And what this does is it traumatizes the audience that watched the television.
But Roy, I have scientific proof that the media is partly responsible.
It
because
is.
Listen, the copycat things that have happened since the shooting. Yesterday there was two or three erupting. How that to me is proof that the media is conveying the message and is igniting people all over the land. And I'm not so sure it's simply the guns or the policies. No. There is a media that is responsible for inferno. It's an inferno going across the land, and kids are trying to copycat. How are they hearing about it? Through the media.
That's right. The media is culpable in this, in helping America take the hairpin bend from becoming more noble to become the degenerate third world country it is. And you see, so we just need to point the finger where it really belongs. The media and the kind of people that media get people to elect, because the media does influence, it does twist, you see, and subvert the principles by which this country is founded.
You don't sound very optimistic.
Unless people get the kind of programming that you are doing, and perhaps if I may just boast a little bit, hear the kind of programming, the program that I do, because I try to wake people up. I say, as long as you're emotional, you'll never see clearly. You'll always be programmed. You'll never come to the right conclusion.
Mm-hmm.
But those who want to control you, those who want power over you, got to keep you in this emotional stupor with rock and roll and the art of confusion. You see Clinton, how he's the master of confusion, the master of conflict, of creating contradiction. And after a while, people get so used to being influenced and upset by contradiction, they begin to accept the contradiction as the truth, and the truth as the contradiction.
You took it to the end.